During this video, we'll talk about zinc, which in my opinion is one of the most forgotten minerals out there. A lot of people talk about magnesium or potassium, perhaps vitamin B, but why is zinc forgotten? As it plays such a vital role in a lot of important health markers. I'm looking at examine.com and we can see significant benefits with respect to depression, acne, blood glucose, insulin levels, length of sickness, and the list goes on. Be sure to stay tuned to the end of the video where I'll go over some zinc-rich foods. During this video, we'll do a breakdown of some of the most important benefits of zinc. As well, we'll go over the proper dosage. As well, we'll go over some common signs of a zinc deficiency. And then at the end of the video, we'll discuss some zinc-rich foods, which will allow you to make a good judgment as far as whether you should supplement with it or not. Zinc, it's a molecule in the body that's responsible for over 300 enzymatic processes. We're talking about oxidation, gene expression. We're talking about cell proliferation and signaling. It's one of the important neuromodulators in the body, which simply means that it helps nerves to function and signal properly. And this is one of the reasons why when a zinc deficiency takes place, it can really decrease your energy levels. There's some really interesting stats out there. It shows that for children under the age of 5, 1.4% of their deaths are somewhat related to zinc, whether it's a zinc deficiency or maybe some sort of zinc complication. And I say this in order to paint the picture as far as why zinc supplementation is so important if you're not getting sufficient zinc through your diet. So with respect to benefits, we're gonna break them down into three major benefits. The first being mood and cognition, the second being hormone regulation, and then the third being immune support, overall health, and fighting sickness. First, I want to point out this study here, which says the effect of zinc supplementation on mood states in young women. And this is a great study, in my opinion, as one group of people just had a multivitamin, whereas the other group of people had a multivitamin along with 7 milligrams of zinc for 10 weeks. The study was somewhat controlled. The mean age was 19 and a half years old, and the mean body weight was somewhere around 120 pounds. And it was very clear by the end of the study that the group which was having a multivitamin as well as zinc had a significant decrease in anger, hostility, and depression. And there was a negative relationship between serum zinc levels and the severity of depression symptoms. Now, let's talk about benefit number two, and that's hormone regulation. For those of you that aspire to have a better physique, whether it's build more muscle or lose fat, then you're probably aware that zinc is a well-known supplement to help to optimize your workout regimen. First, let's talk about what zinc can do for your testosterone levels. What is testosterone responsible for? Pretty much everything. When it comes to building muscle, losing fat, if you have low testosterone levels, because I've been there, building muscle was harder, losing weight was challenging. It's almost like even being on a severe caloric deficit still meant that you can't lose weight. Believe me, you want to optimize your testosterone levels through every means necessary. So I've tried a number of natural testosterone boosters. I've used tribulus, fenugreek, saw palmetto, horny goat weed, D-aspartic acid, and the list goes on. And I would say zinc is one supplement that I can say I've noticed a slight mood increase and a slight increase in my workout performance. As shown by this study over here, which shows that zinc did help to increase testosterone levels of healthy adults. And that's important as much of the research is done on either elder people or people with some sort of sickness. This addresses healthy adults and their testosterone levels. I love it. All right, now let's talk about benefit number three, and that's inflammation and immunity. Now, zinc's interaction in the body with inflammation and immunity, it's a bit unique. A lot of people don't realize that inflammation and immunity can go hand in hand. And when you suppress the immune system, you're suppressing a lot of important inflammatory markers, and it goes vice versa. So inflammation plays a fairly important role in the physiological process of defeating diseases, improving tissue function, and recovery from injuries and exercise. It's really neat that zinc has been studied in all kinds of sicknesses, even things like muscle recovery, to colds, to flus, to even AIDS. As you can see, this study shows there was oral zinc supplementation in the treatment of HIV-infected children. Although there was a slight short-term benefit, nothing too significant. Although this study over here was much more positive, it showed that zinc helped against infection by tapping brakes in the immune response. But as per examine.com, there's 13 studies in which they displayed there was a decreased length of sickness. And then there was 11 studies showing that it decreased some of the symptoms of a common cold. It seems based on the research, it really is just dependent on what type of sickness it is. As we can see here in this study, oral zinc sulfate was effective in the treatment of viral warts. So the takeaway is, should you supplement with zinc in order to fight sickness? I wouldn't necessarily say so, but it's more so just important to ensure you're not zinc deficient. Now, let's look at some of the important indicators which can tell you if you're somewhat zinc deficient. Unfortunately, getting a blood test done with your GP doesn't tell the whole story because your zinc levels may be low or they may be high. Now, this is an important marker and it's important feedback, but it doesn't tell the whole story as you may just have a body that's not efficiently using zinc as you would want it to. So the first sign would be hair loss as well as gray hair. I read a lot on Quora, I read a lot on Reddit, and I see all kinds of experiences. Something which intrigued me was that there were people taking too much zinc, I'm talking 40 to 50 milligrams every single day, only to report that they were getting gray hairs. And the reason this may happen is because too much zinc can result in a copper deficiency, and I don't think anybody wants to lose their hair. Sign number two would be taste loss. And your taste buds, they're actually always changing, so this is a better predictor than you may think. As an example, there's a reason why if you start eating spicy foods, eventually they just don't become spicy anymore. So it's something to be mindful of. The third sign would be just a tendency to get sick. If you're getting sick more often than usual, and people are just wondering why you're getting sick so often, this of course doesn't mean you're necessarily zinc deficient, but it's worth paying attention to. And sign number four would be your testosterone levels and your energy levels. And this is something I could really relate to, as there was a year in which I stopped eating meat entirely and I stopped eating a lot of zinc-rich foods. I wasn't supplementing with it. And despite tracking my macros, making sure I had sufficient protein and healthy carbohydrates, my energy levels significantly dropped. And when I reintroduced meat back into my diet, I felt great. Now let's talk about some zinc-rich foods. Meat, firstly, is an excellent source of zinc, particularly red meat. There's stats showing that a 100 gram serving of raw ground beef contains 4.8 milligrams of beef, which is 44% of the daily value, as the daily value is known to be 10 milligrams. Second would be shellfish, and this is great as it's healthy, it's low calorie, a lot less calorie than beef in most cases. And on average, something like 6 medium-sized oysters provide 32 milligrams of zinc, or 291% of your daily value. So the practical way is, if you're somebody that enjoys shellfish, introduce it to your diet, maybe have it twice a week. And third, although this is in order from best to worst, would be legumes like chickpeas, lentils, and beans. They all contain substantial amounts of zinc. So for those of you that are vegetarians, and I realize there is quite a significant amount on my channel, then beans are the next best thing. Now let's talk about dosage. And this is a little bit tricky if you are to supplement it, because pretty much everywhere you read says the healthy amount is 10 milligrams. It almost seems like vitamin D in that case, in which most people take more. And I think with zinc, you can get away with taking a little bit more, particularly for those of you that may be involved in like strenuous exercise and you're working out maybe over 5 hours a week, then perhaps you can get away with some extra zinc. But for everyone else, 10 to 15 milligrams seems to be like a good amount. Me, myself, I wouldn't go over 20 milligrams a day, even for those intervals of time when I'm experimenting with higher doses of zinc, like 20 milligrams. I'll typically run something like 4 weeks on, 4 weeks off, and then 4 weeks on, because I really do see the benefits, particularly across energy levels and sleep. I hope you all found that helpful. If you're new to the channel, then be sure to subscribe. And for everyone else, I really appreciate your support. Be sure to support this video by giving it a like and comment below. And I will look forward to seeing you all next time.